The Whirlpool sandstone has very few fossils in it. It has very, very few fossils. Mostly it is barren, we would say, and that's too bad. As you go upward, though, you start to see a few trace fossils, a few burrows, maybe even Diplocriterion and other traces in that part. The lower part may actually be river deposits, may actually be stream deposits. It's still somewhat debated. The upper part, however, which way were these currents flowing? To the northwest, they were coming out of the southeast. These were sands being carried in from the south.